Hello, and welcome to our service on this Trinity Sunday, the Sunday where we celebrate the three persons of God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Trinity Sunday follows straight on from Pentecost, where the Church is given boldness to proclaim the gospel to all the world, to all creation. So how are you feeling? As we experience new freedoms, do you feel ready to share the love of God with friends and family? The other day I met a couple who were chatting about church, about their experiences. And as I listened, I could tell that someone had tried to evangelise them, but it hadn't really worked. The message they heard was too complicated, something about snow and sheep. Really, it had gone right over their heads. Later, as I reflected on the conversation, I wondered what might have happened if I had asked them, "What do you think God wants of you?" Or, "What do you think God is like?" A conversation starting with their own thoughts and experiences, I think, might have had more success. So if I get the chance again, I pray that I will have the right words to say. And may it be the same for you too, as the Holy Spirit fills each of us with boldness, as we seek to love God and love neighbour and give everyone a way to follow Jesus. So today, on Trinity Sunday, we worship God the Father. We follow the example of God the Son. And we live empowered by God the Holy Spirit. So let's join together with our opening liturgy. What is God like? God is caring and tender. What is God like? God is slow to anger. What is God like? God is rich in kindness. What is God like? God welcomes all with love. Be strong and happy. Help one another. We will walk together in joy. Work with each other. Live in peace and justice. We will walk together in hope. Strive to follow the way of Christ. Bless one another. We will walk together in love. And so let us now say the confession together. Father, you come to meet us when we turn to you. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, you died on the cross for our sins. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Spirit, you give us life and peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. So may God grant us peace, wholeness, and freedom from fear. Amen. And now we listen to our reading from Matthew's Gospel.
A reading from St. Matthew's Gospel. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age."
Good evening. I wonder how you've been doing this week. Well, last week I had put up a hammock in the garden as my place of escape. But what with the change in the weather, I've struggled a bit more being cooped up indoors than I have done in previous weeks. It has turned my mind a little though, and I've been thinking ahead to post-lockdown, or at least to a time where restrictions are eased much more. I've been reflecting about what might give me a sense of purpose. I've had this long-standing desire to do a long paddle in my kayak, and I've been chatting with a vicar mate of mine, and we're going to look to do a paddle of the Thames from Source to Westminster, 135 odd miles. Well, you can always give me a shout if nearer the time you want to join us for some of it. Another thing that a number of us have contemplated doing is walking a good part of the Camino de Santiago, the Way of St. James, which ends up in northwestern Spain, to go on a pilgrimage. Well, perhaps having a goal of doing something in the future is a good and healthy thing to do. I wonder if you're looking forward to doing anything for the future. Perhaps it's simply looking forward and making plans to see family you haven't been able to see. Or perhaps it's planning that holiday that you've missed this year. It doesn't have to be something adventurous, but having a sense of purpose is really important. It can help give life and life-giving meaning, especially at those times where we otherwise might struggle. And I think it's no different for the disciples. In our reading this week, we are transported back in time again. Jesus meets with the 11 of them on the mountain. He commissions them and he gives them a promise. And this gives them a huge sense of purpose. "Go out and make disciples of all nations," Jesus says, "baptizing in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you." They followed him for 3 years through the highs and the lows of as we've been following the last few weeks. And here is Jesus ready to send them out with a mission, with a job to do. And the word mission comes from the Latin word for being sent. And commission is being sent with the authority and backing of the one who sent you. When you are commissioned, you are entrusted. For example, army officers, when they are commissioned, are trained and entrusted to lead other soldiers in all situations. In the same way, the disciples have been trained up by Jesus. They have followed him and his teachings. And Jesus commissions them, entrusts them with what was entrusted to him: to go into the world and make disciples. But what does that mean? What does it look like? I was sent a video clip yesterday with Anne Morrissey, a Christian writer and thinker, sharing her thoughts. When she was asked what mission was, she said it's about encouraging people to follow Jesus, Jesus the man. And if you follow Jesus the man, that poses questions that take more pondering. But I reckon Jesus the man. And I really like what she says. For isn't that what we're called to do? To follow Jesus and encourage others to follow Jesus too. Jesus the man. Well, I think though that sometimes in the Church of God, some of us have come to believe that making disciples is an aggressive act of theological jiu-jitsu, knocking people into faith with weighty evangelism or clever arguments, doing discipleship to people, whatever that means. But 2 weeks ago, when we looked at Jesus' parting words to his disciples, He talked about being witnesses. And there's a difference between being a witness and just doing evangelism, isn't there? Russ Parker, another Christian writer and priest, says, "People can say the right words, but there's something about them which negates it all because they haven't got the quality of what they're saying. When Jesus says you will be a witness, he didn't say your evangelism skills will be amazing. He said you will be a witness." And perhaps that's helpful for us to reflect on. And how might we do that? Well, we go into the world and we share the good news of what God has done for us and continues to do with those around us. And we do this through the example of our everyday lives, helping those we know to love God and to love neighbour, and also to encourage people to follow Jesus, the man, and as we go and baptise all those who become followers in his way. What a great commission. What a great purpose for his disciples to have and for us to share in today. But that's not all. Jesus gave them a commission and this wonderful promise. He says, "I am with you always to the end of the age." And so in all our witnessing, in all our life, the Holy Spirit of our Father God, the Spirit of Jesus, is with us until the end of the age. And as we share in his purpose, in his mission, in his work, he is there with us. He is walking alongside us in all that we do. And so may God bless us as we look to find purpose in faith and life this week. And may we know the comforting presence of the Spirit of God with us in all that we do. Amen.
Let's now pause for a moment to reflect on this past week, and in this moment of silence, to bring ourselves reverently and thankfully into the presence of our loving Father God. Keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy in this time of uncertainty and distress. Sustain and support the anxious and fearful, and lift up all who are brought low, that we may rejoice in your comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love. In the name of Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. To the bidding, "Lord, hear us," the response is, "Lord, graciously hear us." Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, high and holy God, robed in majesty, Lord of heaven and earth, we pray that you will bring justice, faith, and salvation to all peoples everywhere. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, you chose us in Christ to be your people and to be the temple of your Holy Spirit. We pray that you will fill your church with vision and hope and renewal. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, your Spirit enables us to cry, "Abba, Father," affirms that we are fellow heirs with Christ, and pleads for us in our weakness. We pray for all who are in need or distress. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, in the baptism and birth of Jesus, you have opened heaven to us and enabled us to share in your glory. The joy of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit from before the world was made. May your whole church, living and departed, come to a joyful resurrection in your city of light. Accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. And the Collect for Trinity Sunday. Holy God, faithful and unchanging, enlarge our minds with the knowledge of your truth, and draw us more deeply into the mystery of your love, that we may truly worship you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And let's join together in the words of our benefice prayer. Ever living, ever loving God, we thank you for our church family and your world that we serve. Grant that we may honour you in our prayer and praise. Share the good news of your love and build up all through loving service. Help us to give everyone a place to belong and a way to follow Jesus. Amen. Rejoicing in God's new creation, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen.
And so we conclude our service with a blessing and acclamation. God the Father, who first loved us and formed us in the beloved Son, bless you. Amen. God the Son, who loved us and washed us from our sins, bless you. Amen. God the Holy Spirit, who sows the love of God in our hearts, bless you. Amen. And the blessing of the one true God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to whom be all love and all glory for ever and ever, come down upon you and remain with you always. Amen. You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honour and power. For you have created all things, and by your will they have their being. You are worthy, O Christ, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed us for God. From every tribe and language and nation, you have made us to be a kingdom and priests serving our God. To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing and glory and honour and might for ever and ever. Amen. May you have a wonderful week. And we look forward to catching up with you soon.
You paint the skies in their brilliance, igniting stars in their millions, creating the landscape from nothing. with